can. You know, just add in some more rooms, just with some windows. Y'all are literally touching your neighbor's property. I'm mad looking at this, okay? And wondering how these people live. I hope y'all got curtains or something. I mean, at least you could steal their Wi-Fi and still get a good signal. Now, I've seen so many of these pictures and I still don't have an explanation as to why people decide to put two toilets smack down right next to each other. Like, why? You barely even have enough leg room to sit on it. Are y'all sitting like on the side, like facing outwards? Or are two people gonna use it at the same time? I know some places they got like a toilet and a bidet, but they have two different uses. These are two regular toilets. One is slightly shorter than the other. Maybe Daddy Bear can bond with his child over a nice fat poo after having Taco Bell. That's the only explanation. Otherwise, why are they so close to each other? Candy scented hand sanitizer. Okay, hold on. So we got candy all over the display, like blow pop, double bubble gum. Is it candy or is it hand sanitizer? I know it says hand sanitizer, but like, is that really apparent enough? Is a child gonna get one of these and be like, smells delicious? At least the inside of me is clean. I've been looking at this ad, I'm like trying to figure out what it is. Is it a cereal? Is it bleach? Is it for your hair? Is it a snack? What is it? What is the puffball with eyes and angel ears? I think it's a hair dye. Yeah, it says White Star Hair. It's for your hair. Why is there milk in cereal? Is this what happens when you bleach your hair? Puffball makes some star cereal. I don't know. I keep thinking, like, I can't get any more annoyed. And then you have this sink. Tried so hard and got so far. In the end, it's a disgrace. You disgrace your existence as a sink. Or is it the faucet's fault? Maybe it's the faucet. Which is to blame? The faucet or the sink? Comment below. No, it's the person who installed these. You are a fool, sir. You know, we have this beautiful cutout on the ceiling. They made it so fancy. And we're gonna hang a chandelier right on the side of it. It's a freaking circle. The chandelier is supposed to be hung inside of it. It's like you were trying to make people mad. Maybe they really hated having people over. And anytime somebody came over and they were like, oh, hi. Notice our new chandelier. And you take one look at that and you're like, what's wrong with these people? I mean, that's your cue to like run. Get out of there. These are foes, not friends. If you hang your chandelier like this, we can't be friends. But anyways, that's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Comment below which one of these was the worst. Frustrated you to heck. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to hit the like button and the pics. And make sure you turn on notifications. Click. And subscribe, join the whole pack. Oh, I love you guys so much. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys. Me. You walk into the store, you ask for some Oreos. What? I never heard of no Oreos. But we got some cream between. Basically the same thing. You got the blue packaging and everything. You know, fun fact, Oreos were not the original chocolate sandwich cookie. It was actually these, Hydrox, America's first cream-filled cookie. Oreos were just the one that popped off because ain't nobody want to eat a cookie called a Hydrox. That sounds like some car parts. It's not something I want to dip in milk. We got Kellogg's Frosted Flakes. And we got Crown Fields Frosted Flakes. They're acceptable.
There's a goofy looking naked bear version. What animal is this? Is he a lion? It's literally whatever the animal beast is
from Beauty and the Beast. That's that animal that's on the Frosted Flakes. Nailed it. I grew up with a Game Boy, but a child somewhere in the world grew up with a Game Child. I bet if it was made in 2019, it wouldn't be called a Game Boy. It would